That's up back behind the Stars goal as we approach 6 minutes remaining here in the third period. 2-2 our score. Out it comes down to Sharp. Crisscrossing. Darts into the zone to the forehand. He scores! Patrick Sharp has given the Stars the lead once again at 3-2.
It's quite a rush. I mean, he went blasting through there. This is pretty close to being offside because of Antoine Roussel was sort of spinning as they come over the line. Sharp goes interior. Did Roussel hang on? I think he did. I think he kept the toenail onside. And then Sharp just in one move to the forehand on Weber, backed him off with that blistering speed and goes five hole. He got bettered by Miller on a breakaway back in the second period. This one is just a fluid move to the forehand and deposited. Tweeners.
And they are going to challenge this razor as Kelly Sutherland went over to the bench. Willie Desjardins indicating that they want to take a look at this.
It's worth a shot.
Vancouver is challenging the play. See if it was offside prior to the goal.
6 minutes left in regulation. A one-shot game. This either keeps it tied and maybe a chance of at least picking up a point. Sharp's hoping that the toenail was onside of Antoine Roussel. Well, he's had quite a game tonight, too. That flip-flop of those right wingers has been marvelous. Just marvelous. It's going to be close.
Yeah.
That angle's a tough one to see from the other end of the rink, sort of. And again, the easier ones to challenge are always these ones in the first and third period. Well, pull the groin trying to stay onside. I think he's onside.
Yeah.
On the near side, 21. I think he spun and kept himself onside. The linesmen are taking a look at this. Not the officials, because they're the guys that call the lines. And Mike Civic's down there, all 6'11" of them or whatever it is. It's his last game he'll ever work here in Vancouver. How about this? He worked his first game, 88. That's him. His first game was in 1987 at Pacific Coliseum. His first ever NHL game.
Wow.
So they got to wait. They'll figure out on their massive screen down there. Here's a good look at it. Antoine in the background.
Yeah. They just showed a different look on the big board here. And there was a reaction from the crowd, but even that look that they had, it is so close.
They were slowing right down. It's tough to tell because I think he's onside.
Yeah, it looks like his toe of that blade is just on the line.
Kept his right toe back there. And that's the question, too, is, was it on the ice?
Right.
Was his foot on the ice? Miller had been keeping the Stars at bay. Reese and Miller having quite an animated discussion up top. Kills the momentum. Stars have outshot the Canucks 30-15. They've been the better squad. If this counts, they're up by one. They keep showing it on the board at center ice from the high view in the arena. It's a goal on the ice, and they'd have to be able to figure it out without a shadow of a doubt to overturn it.
Well, both Mike Civic and Don Henderson, the linesman, have looked at it enough now to have a decision.
Well, you get to a point where you need one. I know they want to get it right, but let's see what they decided.
On video review, the call on the ice stands. There's a good goal.
Those in victory green here at Rogers Arena in full throat after that, the double celebration. Patrick Sharp with a beautiful individual tally on that one. And those stretching exercises for Antoine Roussel have paid off. He could hang in long enough to stay onside.
So both coaches now.